Pullman Stories, Railroading and Cherie.
I should have recorded that.
Wait, check my hair. All right, so what are we discussing? This is so nice.
What? Yes. Cherie? Mm-hmm. Why French?
That's a very interesting question. My mother wanted to go to France, and at that time, I was born. And so this was her trip.
Oh, wow. Well, she had a wonderful trip.
She did.
Are you as awesome outside of work as you are in work?
Yes, I am. I keep this energy flow going most of the time. I do.
Got kids?
No, I do not.
Not yet.
I do not. I come from a very large family, though. I'm the baby of 9 children.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. So there are a lot of little ones around. I've moved around too much. I've been too selfish to have children on my own, but I have plenty of nieces and nephews. Bye now. See you later. Alrighty.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. My pleasure. So is that my 15 seconds?
No, you got more.
I got more?
Yeah, so we have at least 7, 8, 10 minutes here.
Found your hat, huh? I almost raffled it off.
I started
working for Amtrak about 2 years ago, and it all started with the trip. I took a train trip myself, and the attendant was, I had so much fun with him. I said, I think I'd like to do his job. And about 5, 6 years later, I was looking for work, and there on Craigslist popped up Amtrak, and I read the requirements, and I said, that's the job. And I fired off an email, and they said, we'd like to talk to you. And I said, I'd like to talk to you.
Wow, now where do you go from?
I work at a Seattle base, and so we travel between Seattle and Chicago. It's a small base, so this is the only Ryanair Pride Builder that we work on.
Okay, so when you get on, it's like a stewardess almost.
It is exactly, it's the same type of thing, but it's much more intense. I have 3 crafts that I can do. I either work in the dining room as a dining car attendant, or I work in the sleeping car as a sleeping car attendant, or I can work in the coach. So we do a little bit more than the flight attendants do.
Oh, I'm sure you do.
Yes, yeah. I'm required to make beds, I'm required to greet people, make sure everyone's comfortable, I serve your food, and make sure you're entertained.
You're awesome.
And then I make sure people get on and get off where they're supposed to. We clean bathrooms, we do it all. You get on this train, we take good care of you.
So you're out of Seattle, so you live in Seattle.
Yes, I live in Seattle right now. Yes, up
in Seattle proper?
Up in Capitol Hill.
Okay.
Yes. I am originally from Brooklyn, New York, though.
That's right. I picked up the accent. Sounded like Jersey.
That's right. Close enough. You're close enough. When I get excited, people think I'm from Jersey. Yeah. So we're Brooklyn, New York. That's where I'm originally from. That's it.
And that's where your family's from?
Most of my family is still in, from Indiana, from the Midwest to the East Coast.
Huh?
I'm the only one here on the West Coast, and I'm waiting for my transfer to go back to the East Coast as well.
Oh, you're gonna go back home.
I'm gonna go back over to Brooklyn, and hopefully I'll work out of the Washington D.C. crew base.
Oh, wow, that sounds cool.
Yeah, it's fun. It's the most exciting job I've ever had, and I've done a number of things. I was a clerk for the New York Commodity Exchange. I was there the first time they bombed. I left New York just before 9/11.
Wow.
So I've worked printing presses, I've done, a number of things, but this is the most interesting job I've ever had, and the most fun. I get to see an amazing countryside, meet great folks, there's no pressure, all I have to do is get on here and make sure that you're having a good time. That's easy to do.
I'm having a wonderful time.
Good.
But tell me, you love the people, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's just wonderful.
I do. I've met a lot of interesting people. It's better than riding the plane because people are willing to have a conversation with you. They're willing to spend time and tell you what's going on, where they're traveling to, what they do for a living. They're sharing pictures and stories of their grandkids and things like that. And so it's a lot of fun. I've met a lot of interesting people. And it's good. I like having these little moments in time.
This is wonderful. And you have a whole bunch of old men stories.
Yes.
I mean,
yes.
Your life is about old men stories.
That's right.
See, old men stories about... It doesn't have anything to do with a man, it's just human.
That's right.
And it's about feeding these stories in your life.
That's right.
And the more stories you tell, the more you know about yourself, because telling your own story to you adds value.
Yeah.
Because you get who you are.
That's
You forget how unique you are in the universe.
It's true. And it's fun.
You are very special in the universe.
Well, thank you. I'd like to think so.
Oh, I know so. I'm an observer.
Thank you.
I come from out there, you know.
Yeah, good. It's a lot of fun. And I think that's what life is supposed to be. It's supposed to be about a lot of these little moments.
What's your last name, Sherry?
Jackson.
Say, Sherry Jackson, Omen Stories.
That's right.
I want to hear that. Let's say that right now.
Okay, Sherry Jackson, Pullman Stories.
Pullman, I love it.
Excellent. Thank you so much. That was fun.
Okay. Omen Stories, one more day.